Hello, today's topic is dot blot technique. Importance of dot blot technique is, by means of this technique, it is possible to detect specific RNA, DNA or protein in a specimen like blood, serum, CSF, sputum and other body fluids accurately. Whenever ELISA test results do not clearly indicate any specific disease, dot blot techniques are extremely useful since these are fast, sensitive, specific, accurate and precise. These techniques detect these molecules present in very small concentration, as low as picogram, and you know it very well that 1000 picograms are equal to 1 nanogram. By dot blot technique, it is possible to diagnose various diseases caused by viruses, bacteria and fungi, such as COVID-19, SARS, swine flu, HIV, tuberculosis, candida, dengue fever, chikungunya, etc. You must have information of principles of following procedures to understand dot blot technique. These are electrophoresis, hybridization, DNA probe preparation and DNA probe label attachment. First, we will consider electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is separation of various proteins and DNA molecules in a specimen on a suitable medium, on a suitable membrane like nitrocellulose under the influence of electrical current. For more information, refer to our medical biochemistry book, page 33, chapter 1, or medical laboratory technology textbook, page 91, chapter 4. Hybridization is the interaction between two single-stranded nucleic acid molecules, one sense type and another antisense type, to form a double-stranded molecule based on the complementary base pairing of their respective bases, as shown on the left-hand side. DNA probe is a DNA molecule of known sequence to which a label is attached. The label can be an enzyme like alkaline phosphatase, or it can be a radioactive substance or a fluorescent substance. The DNA probe hybridizes with unknown DNA complementary strand, as shown on the left hand side. In the making of a probe, the specific DNA fragment is first attached with a biotin molecule, then biotin molecule is attached with a streptavidin molecule, and then streptavidin molecule is attached with an enzyme like alkaline phosphatase or a radioactive substance or a fluorescent substance, as shown on the left hand side. Let us now see how a southern blot technique is followed. First, patient's throat swab is collected if there is a respiratory tract infection. Then the transport medium, which is used to isolate DNA of infectious organism, is then treated by PCR technology, as I have already explained in my video on PCR and RT-PCR methodology. This information of PCR is also given in all our books. The DNA obtained from PCR technology, that is cDNA, is then treated with specific restriction enzymes to make fragments of cDNA. The fragments of cDNA then separated by using agarose gel electrophoresis. On agarose gel, a nitrocellulose membrane is then placed on the top, and at the bottom, filter paper pads are placed as shown on the left hand side. By this means, the DNA fragments are transferred to nitrocellulose membrane, and this procedure takes about 2 to 18 hours depending on the specific DNA size, that is of the target DNA. Afterwards, nitrocellulose membrane is placed in a buffer solution containing a known specific DNA probe attached with specific label, as I have already explained earlier. Then incubation is performed for about 30 minutes to 2 hours. After incubation, the nitrocellulose membrane is washed with a wash buffer and then flooded with a substrate. For alkaline phosphate is labeled, paranitrophenyl phosphate is used as a substrate. And if patient's DNA and probe hybridization takes place, then alkaline phosphatase will act on paranitrophenyl phosphate and formation of yellow colored bands will take place due to formation of nitrophenol. If specific DNA is absent, then no hybridization will take place and there is no color formation and no colored bands will appear on the membrane. If probe label is a chromophore, then it is excited by specific light as directed by the test protocol. And if a radioactive label is used, then UV illuminator is used to detect specific bands of target DNA. The complete standard operation procedure SOP is as shown on the left hand side. Northern blot technique is used to analyze a sample of RNA from a particular tissue or cell type in order to measure the RNA expression of particular genes. And the procedure is exactly the same as for southern blot technique. Only thing is, instead of DNA, in this case RNA is used. In western blot technique, proteins in a specimen are fractionated by polyacrylamide gel PAGE electrophoresis, and then the separated pattern is then transferred to nitrocellulose membrane as I have described earlier, and then the nitrocellulose membrane is stained by using Kumari blue staining solution. The fractionated proteins are then compared with a known fractionated pattern of proteins to identify the individual proteins. Example of western blotting is identification of viral antigenic proteins of HIV. For that purpose, first cDNA is obtained from white blood cells of a patient's blood. cDNA then fragmented by restriction enzymes, and then this mixture is used for PAGE electrophoresis for separation of various antigenic proteins of HIV. Just see on the left hand side how antigenic proteins of HIV are separated. For more information of PAGE, refer to page 93 of our MLT book. A dot slot or a dot blot technique is simplification of southern, northern and western techniques, and results can be obtained in only 5 to 6 hours. Let us take example of COVID-19 identification by this method. The polypropylene membrane of blot slot plate, as shown on the left hand side, is attached with complementary DNA strand of COVID-19. First, cDNA from patient sample is added to it. Incubation is performed and after incubation plate is washed. Then a standard radio-labeled complementary DNA strand is added, and after incubation then autoradiography is performed. If patient sample contains COVID-19 DNA, then dark color dot will indicate that. And the SOP of this procedure is shown on the left hand side. Various cytokines can also be identified by dot slot technique. Well, in all these dot blot techniques, various laboratory principles are used, like ELISA, electrophoresis, spectrophotometry, densitometry, autoradiography, etc. I hope this presentation is very useful for you to prepare for semester examinations. You will get answers for various questions as I have shown on the left hand side. I thank you all for your support and wish you all the best for your ensuing examinations. Thank you.